person just sings, writes their own lyrics. It's,
although Thurston wrote the lyrics to Plastic Sun.
Although I wrote the lyrics to Plastic Sun, so, which Kim sings. But so that something. Happens once in a while.
It's fun to sing, like, you know, when he writes for my point of view or something, and it really fools people, and yeah. It's also kind of, I don't know, I just think it's really funny.
Sometimes I write him as if I'm sort of kind of like a feminist.
Pistol woman.
A pistol woman, not a feminist, a pistol
that
woman.
That song that we originally did for Jane Magazine, yeah. And I mean, I always took the lyrics to be kind of like about how fashion magazines package that attitude in girls, and that it was something.
No, actually, I wrote the lyrics as if I was Pat Place in 1979, actually.
Anybody who knows Thurston particularly well knows that he's probably never really imagined himself as anything else. You know, Thurston copped, if not half his moves, I'd say three quarters of his move from Pat Place. You know, Pat was a very credible songwriter in her day.
He brought his guitar out there. The neck is cracked.
How is that show?
Like here, look, it's all cracked. That's why it's all floppy. It doesn't hold the tuning.
Bummer. why don't we just smash it on camera right now?
Why don't we?
This next song is entitled Plastic Sun.
No.
Shit, I thought I had
no.
it. No. I really thought I had it.
Oh, I'm sorry. This next song is titled Radical Adults Lick Godhead Style.
In the style of God.
Radical Adults Lick. And it got a DeVita.
I actually like this little piece of paper that you sent out. I thought it was quite, I like the little historical perspective. Right.
Is that Byron's piece?
I don't know.
Byron Coley's.
He wrote a bunch of lies.
It's kind of a method that some other people have used. Take five or six songs, you just cut them down, keep cutting them down on cassette, and then once it's done, you have the whole thing sort of put together. Radical Adults, you know, it's funny because that in a way, crafts two of the weirder things together. I mean, there's a bunch of it I think is kind of based on some of the Juarez just kind of a country opera written by the video artist Terry Allen from Texas. I think I've got it up here. Yeah. Most of the lyrical borrowings that were taken on here were done by cut-up, so they don't necessarily pop out that easily. But I can remember them borrowing this record at that time. There was another electronic part that was more, it was kind of the American Indian electronic part, though. This is the period when Buffy St. Marie had a little electronic flowering with Peter Schickley from PDQ Bach. And I know that that had a big influence on Kim. She said when she lived in Hawaii that really her family listened to a lot of Buffy St. Marie all the time together, and that they would do a lot of Buffy St. Marie style singing. And at the same time, she was starting to get into electronic music, so she would sometimes play some sort of a crude synthesizer along while the family did Buffy St. Marie songs. And that when this album came out, that was really integral to, you know, the way that she thought that songs would be put together.
You're playing, you've got the DVD player open. Do you see your thing that says DVD player? So quit that.
Do Apple kill now before you're killed.
Okay, I'm going to tickle you, please.
Why don't we just cancel the tour and like play with our computers all summer?
We can answer the phone and check email.
I don't think I want a tour now. Okay, I'll play a song, one of those old horrible songs. Let's play new stuff. Let's write a new song. I have a couple ideas.
My disc